Hello again everybody, and welcome to another instructional video from Skookum Robotics. In today's video, we're walking through the functions of the Futaba 8FG transmitter as they relate to the Skookum Robotics SK720's initial setup software. Starting from the transmitter's requirements in the initial setup wizard, you set your swashplate mode in the linkage menu. Access this menu by tapping the LNK button twice. Then scroll down to Model Type, then select the Swash option. One servo mode is called H1 on Futaba radios. Subtrims are also found in the linkage menu. Hit the LNK button twice, and scroll through the menu to the Subtrim option. Adjust each channel until they read +0. The channel endpoints are also found in the linkage menu. These are used to adjust the cyclic and tail gains if you haven't set a locked value in your SK720. Scroll to the channel you've selected to control your gains, and change the leftmost and rightmost values to set your gain value. The leftmost number sets the upper switch position, and the rightmost number sets the lower switch position. To change the bank each switch position controls, reverse that channel's direction in the reverse function, also found in the linkage menu. If you need your transmitter's auxiliary channels for another purpose, you can lock the gain settings on the SK720 software. In the Control tab, select None in the Cyclic Gain Channel and Tail Gain Channel menus. The Cyclic 2 and Tail 2 tabs disappear, and you can select a locked cyclic and tail gain setting. The last function we're going to look at in the linkage menu is the throttle cut. This function is used when setting the throttle idle in the SK720. On an electric heli, set it to 0%. On a nitro, set it to a steady idle. You can also select the switch controlling the throttle cut using the SW menu at the bottom of the screen. Dual rates and expo are found in the model menu. Hit the MOL button twice, then select dual rates. Scroll through each channel and set each value to 100. You can turn off any expo in this menu by setting the value for each channel to +0. You can also reset any throttle and pitch curves in the model menu. Starting with the pitch curve, the values going from top to bottom should be reset to 100, 50, 0, negative 50, and negative 100. Moving on now to the throttle curve, you should reset the values from top to bottom to 100, 75, 50, 25, and 0. As always, if you have any questions, you can send us an email or check the wiki using the links in the description. Thanks for watching.